So we got the fences all squared away. I got the north side done, and Ernie, I think the south side fences look good. We're good to go.
I'll tell you what, just be glad we got it over before tomorrow with the storm coming in.
And so we got a lot of episodes showing about winter riding. And welcome to Better Horses. I'm Ed Adams.
And I'm Ernie Rodina. We're so glad you joined us today. We got a tremendous show. Ed, tell us what's going on.
Well, we're going to start off with Alexis Losey, all the way from Pleasant Hill, Missouri, on a dressage rider. And she's going to show us the great use of a bucking strap.
And then what we're going to do is we're going to have an encore of an earlier episode of Better Horses TV with Jerry Diaz and his family putting on the Charro experience. You're going to love it.
I enjoyed that segment. And then we're going to head down to Phil Haugen's going to give us a new shot of what it's like to ride a horse with flexible hands.
He's the real deal. You're going to love that.
Well, that sounds like an exciting show. So stay with us with Better Horses, the only horse show on your local broadcast television station.
Go wake up, Grandma, Grandpa, Mom and Dad. Get the neighbor kids up. Better Horses TV is just about ready to start, and you're going to love it.
We'll be right back.
In a natural, free-roaming situation, horses graze nearly constantly throughout the day and night. When feeding horses in stables, it's ideal to try to mimic this feeding behavior. Horses in stabled conditions should be fed their hay so they can pick at it continuously between feedings. Visit our website at stanleyforage.com under Nutrition, then Nutritional Resources, to help transition your horse from winter to spring in the coming weeks.
Hi, I'm Justin McKee for Better Horses. And you know, when you make a living in agriculture, man, it's going to be a struggle. Sometimes we have disappointments and disasters that'll just hit us right between the eyes and make us question, God, where are you? Let me tell you how we can crawl out of those situations that we've all been in, and that is to be thankful. Philippians 4 says, if we will not be anxious, don't be anxious about anything, but through prayer and thanksgiving, make your request made to God, and then the peace of God will surpass everything you ever imagined. Being thankful sets up everything. Being thankful allows us to have clarity in our mind. Clarity allows us to hear His wisdom, hear His voice. Being thankful leads to clarity, and clarity leads to His wisdom instead of your emotions. That's a winner every time.
No matter what discipline of riding you do, training, showing, and everyday stress is hard on your horse's legs. Dekra Veterinary Products is a leading lameness company that brought you OsFos. OsFos is a clodronate injection and intramuscular bisphosphonate to help control the clinical signs of navicular syndrome in horses 4 years and older. Ask your veterinarian if OsFos is right for your horse. Dekra Veterinary Products is a proud sponsor of The American.
What do you get when you bring together one of the biggest names in veterinary medicine with one of the most caring and committed teams of horse health experts in the industry? You get a vaccine portfolio known for its quality and safety. A pharmaceutical line you can rely on to help manage pain and support performance. You get the products, programs, and people of Merck Animal Health.
Hi, my name is Alexis Losey. I'm a dressage instructor from Pleasant Hill, Missouri, and welcome to Better Horses TV. Today I am talking about how I start a fresh young horse. This is Wish on a Star. She is a 3-year-old Oldenburg mare, and she has been under saddle with me about 3 months. So she's green, and she is learning, and she has a hot temperament. So I'm going to be showing how I use a bucking strap to help her find her balance as she is 3 and learning. And the bucking strap helps me teach her balance. It also helps me if she wants to be playful, if she wants to buck, if she wants to rip the reins out of my hand. It teaches her that she cannot do these naughty behaviors, and she has to yield to the bit. So I take my outside rein, which is my right hand, take the right rein through the bucking strap, and I shorten it to the desired length, and then I hold it. Now, if she pulls, she's pulling against the strap and not my arm as bad. So I'm using the leverage of the strap, and it doesn't use as much energy for myself. The type of bit I am using today is a double-jointed D-ring snaffle manufactured by Herm Springer. It is what I start all my young horses in because it delivers the most clear information to a young horse. It's soft and gentle, but it gives clear direction. So in the cold weather, right now it's snowing and ice on the ground. She cannot get out all her energy and her rambunctiousness outside. So before I get on my young horses, I lunge them. And it depends on how she's feeling is how long I lunge to get out most of the playfulness. And then I get on once I know that she's not going to buck me off. Now I am going to walk her around both directions and then trot and canter and teach her some things. So let's get started. So I have my outside rein, which is my right rein, through the bucking strap. Because she's a three-year-old, she's unbalanced, and she's young, and she's learning self-carriage. So when we do transitions, she likes to throw her head up, throw her head down, and brace against my hand. So this prevents her from ripping the rein through my hand. She is now fighting against the saddle and not my body. So it gives me greater leverage to work her through a problem. So as I go up to trot, you can see I hold my hand up and see she's trying to pull. I add my leg, push her through, but I don't let my outside rein move. She has to give to the bit. My inside hand stays neutral, doesn't do anything. It just kind of guides her around the circle. My legs urge her to go forward. And she is very frisky today, which is not a problem. I don't care. Good. And as she relaxes, she will drop her head, and then I can relax my connection on the outside rein. Good girl. Good girl. So now as we go up to canter, she might play, but I'm going to push her through it. Good girl. Good. Super girl. Good girl. Good. So she's light here in my hand. She's learning her balance. That's all right. She stopped by herself. So I'm going to ask again. Good. Super. But I can use my outside bucking strap so she knows the length of neck that I want her to have. Add a little leg here to keep her going. Super. And you see she has a nice round frame. She is, well, that's all right. She lost her balance. Baby horses have a hard time with their balance. So when they lose it, they break to trot. No big deal. You just have the opportunity to ask her again for the canter part. Good girl. So what I'm looking for is a giving. Good. This position here with her neck. Add a little leg. Add a little leg. She's soft in both my hands. She's round. She's not fighting me. She's cantering. That's all right. Over her back. Good. And here in the trot, what I'm looking for, yep, she thinks she gets to stop. What I'm looking for is this here where she's stretching. She's super soft in both my hands. She's carrying her neck in the correct position. She's round. Good baby. Good baby. But this takes practice for her to build the muscles and the muscle strength to keep this speed. I don't want her to go faster. I don't want her to go slower. And I want her to stay, be nice and soft. Good girl. And the bucking strap just helps me to accomplish it so she knows the boundaries and the perimeter of the length of neck that I want her to have. Good. Work. Good. Walk on. So that is how I work with young horses using a bucking strap. My name is Alexis Losey. Thank you for watching Better Horses TV.
Hey folks, don't go anywhere. We've got more Better Horses coming to you right after this from our sponsors.
Equifest 2020 has moved to Salina, Kansas on March 6th, 7th, and 8th. The largest equine expo in the Midwest with food, art, workshops, clinics, shopping, and more. Showcasing everything equine. Details at equifestofkansas.com.
I've been using a CSI saddle pad for about 4 years now. It is very important in barrel racing for your horse to be comfortable and sound, and the CSI saddle pad does that. My saddle always sits in the correct spot on my horse's withers and down his back and never rolls. I am very comfortable when I ride a CSI saddle pad. I feel balanced and my saddle does not feel like it rolls on any of my horses.
Equifest 2020 has moved to Salina, Kansas on March 6th, 7th, and 8th. The largest equine expo in the Midwest with food, art, workshops, clinics, shopping, and more. Showcasing everything equine. Details at equifestofkansas.com.
Hello friends, Ernie Rodina here with Better Horses TV, having a wonderful time at the new Vollen Arena in Vollen, Kansas, and I'm here with the man. I'm talking about Jerry Diaz, unbelievable horseman, friend, and everything. Welcome to Kansas and the inaugural event at Vollen Arena.
First of all, Mr. Ernie, it's great to see you. You and I go back a very long time. It's a true honor and a blessing to be here in this beautiful town of Alma, Kansas here. For the inauguration of this beautiful arena here with the family of Patty and Jerry Reese. They are wonderful people. I have a big part of my heart from Kansas. We've performed many times here in Kansas. We're an honorary member at the Saddle and Sirloin Club. We're an ambassador for Purina Mills, and I just feel like part of the family.
Well, you are part of the family, and this event that we have coming up here. What about this arena that Mr. Jerry Reese built just for this occasion and other events that are going to be coming through the area?
Absolutely. Mr. Jerry Reese is not going to do anything to halfway. He'll do it all the way to a perfection. He called me several times. He laid it out. And as you can see, the arena is just absolutely beautiful. And it's my honor to do this opening here at this arena with my lovely wife, Stacy, and my son, Nicolas, who now is 15 years old. I wish the people that didn't make it, or will make it, come and see us because it's something unique and beautiful.
Tell us what we're going to see. Give us a little sample of what we're going to see tonight.
Well, Ernie, I'm a fourth generation Charro. I carry on the legacy of my father, my grandfather, my great-grandfather from the South. My great-grandfather was from Spain. So this evening, what people will see is the Charro tradition. The rope artistry that has been handed down to me for many generations, and the horsemanship. It takes 6 to 8 years to school a horse. We're gonna display beautiful Andalusians, a beautiful quarter horse. Most of all is the horsemanship and the family connection with my wife, with her horse, my son with this horse. And we have a surprise toward the end of the show that's something that my son Nicholas has created. Because the horsemanship is in his blood.
You know, this is going to be a great event that we're going to have on here, but what does the Flint Hills bring to it? Is it not unbelievable?
A spirit. A spirit. The Flint Hills in itself, so much history here in the Flint Hills. It's if you ever want to be close to God in Kansas, you need to come to the Flint Hills. These days that we've been here, Mr. Ernie, we've been riding out there in the beautiful rancher, Mr. Patty and Jerry Race, and at night, close to the stars, open pasture. If you ever want to stop and reflect, you need to be in the Flint Hills, especially when you're with your horse.
Well, I tell you what, this is a special day, special evening to have Jerry Diaz and his family here, showing the talents you have in your artistry. You know, it's an art show here going on, and you're part
Absolutely.
Of that art show right there.
Invite the audience to come out to the art gallery. In the art gallery, not only the art, but there's on display there a beautiful handcrafted saddle that belonged to my father. It's embroidered with pita, and it has silver and gold. The conchas are silver and gold. And then there's a Mexican saddle that I designed for Mr. Jerry Reese for his horses when he rides out there in the Flint Hills. He likes riding in his Mexican saddle, carry on the legacy of the vaquero.
Well, I tell you again, thank you for being a part of Better Horses TV. Thank you for all you bring to the equine industry and what you do for Purina and all your other sponsors.
Thank you very much, Ernie. It's a great pleasure seeing you and spending time with you.
God bless you.
Very excited to be here and being the first equestrian show. We're honored that Mr. Jerry and Patricia Reese invited us to be here with our friends here at the Flint Hills. My wife Stacy and my son Nicholas, and we brought some of our new equestrian horses. This is Calypso, Majestad, Mil Amores, and Universo. So my father used to say that horses don't learn in the stall. You got to take them out and show them and introduce them.
Brought in sponsors from all over to see Jerry and his family perform. Better Horses Media, Purina Animal Nutrition, Merck Animal Health, Stanley Premium Forage, The Vollen Store, Reese Nichols, Tubar D Ranch, Mr. and Mrs. Lee Beatty, Commerce Bank, Kansas Horse Council, Mark and Sharon Simpson, and El Torito Supermart. What a beautiful display of great horsemanship that was performed by Jerry, Stacy, and Nicholas Diaz. Thank you, Jerry and Patty Reese, for making this happen.
Equifest 2020 has moved to Salina, Kansas on March 6th, 7th, and 8th. The largest equine expo in the Midwest with food, art, workshops, clinics, shopping, and more. Showcasing everything equine. Details at equifestofkansas.com.
You care about your animals and feeding them the best. And that's where Purina's local Kansas City dealers step in, providing you experience, knowledge, service, and advice. Purina feed dealers are people who believe in community involvement and who believe in you. They have a passion for the feed industry and are committed to helping customers unlock the potential of every animal. If you are looking for a trusted source for your animals, look no further than your local Purina feed dealer, your partner in animal care.
Equifest 2020 has moved to Salina, Kansas on March 6th, 7th, and 8th, the largest equine expo in the Midwest with food, art, workshops, clinics, shopping, and more, showcasing everything equine. Details at equifestofkansas.com.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining us on this week's episode of Better Horses TV. I want to thank Ernie and Ed for coming down and having us on the show this week. We really appreciate being a part of the show. This week, for this week's training tip, I'm going to talk about softening your horse and keeping your horse following its nose in a turn. This is a really simple exercise, but like today, I worked six or seven colts that I worked on this exercise with, and I do that pretty much every day with every horse because it's really important. Number one, that your horse's body stays soft, and when you tip their nose one way or another, either to the right or to the left, they need to follow their nose with those front feet, okay? Now, a little background on this mare, Reba, she's a heel horse, calf horse that we ride, and last week we had some family down, and we roped a lot of steers, and she ran quite a few steers last week. So this week I'm just going to soften her back up, get her collected, move her around, get her following her nose. So when I start out, I'm just going to put my legs against her rib cage and I'm going to squeeze her forward. Now, when I reach down and pick up this rein, and one other thing I want to talk about first is in an earlier episode I talked about the German Martingale. And that's what I'm using on her today, is a D-ring snaffle and a German Martingale, just to soften her up and get her collected. And when you get your horse collected, you get them round in their back. And when you get them round in their back, they get more balanced on their hindquarter. So I want her moving forward because I always want my horse's front feet moving. Okay, anytime those front feet stop, she's going to get stuck. Okay, so when I reach down and tip this nose, I'm going to squeeze her forward. And right there, when those front feet stepped over, then I released. I want to keep going in this circle. I want her to keep moving off my leg and I want them front feet moving. But when I reach down and pick up on that rein and those front feet step around, then I'm going to release. The reason I release then is because if you'll watch her inside hind leg is going to plant and become that pivot point, okay? When that inside hind leg becomes the pivot point and she steps around with her front end, keeps her front feet moving, then I'm going to release because that's what I'm asking for. So watch her. When I come around, I'll ask her to step across. So watch this leg right here. When I come back around, watch this left hind leg. So I'm going to tip that nose, squeeze her forward. Do you see that left hind leg, how it planted and that front end stepped around? That's what I'm asking for. I always want my horse's front feet moving because in any kind of a performance event, any kind of a speed event, anytime those front feet quit moving, you're losing time. And that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if I'm chasing a calf, a steer, or you're running a barrel pattern. Anytime that front end gets stiff and quits moving, okay, anytime that front end does this, you're losing time, okay? The other thing that happens in a turn is if that front end quits moving and their front end gets stiff like this, the hind quarter has to swing one way or the other. There's no way. Otherwise, it's going to go end over end, and that doesn't happen. Okay, so simple exercise, but if you ever come by my place and you're watching me warm a colt up, this is what I do. Squeeze forward, step them over, keep them front feet moving. When I feel that hind leg become a pivot point, I release. Okay? Great exercise. It's a great exercise to keep your horse's front end moving. Okay? It's a great exercise for your horse to get to balancing on its hindquarters, and it's a great exercise for a horse to keep following its nose with its body. I hope that helps you. And thank you for having us on the show this week. You can follow us on Phil Haugen Horsemanship on Instagram at Phil Haugen Horsemanship. We have a podcast that comes out weekly, Be Your Best Horsemanship. And you can go to our website, philhaugenhorsemanship.com, if you want to contact us there. Have a great week, and God bless.
Hey, Wranglers, we got a lot more Better Horses coming your way right after this word.
Greg and Cole Cameron here on the Old Double Horn Ranch, and today we're going to teach you the fabulous unending pattern. Now, I'll start at a trot, and then push to a canter. I like pushing to that canter in the turn. It's easier for my horse to pick up the correct lead. So I got my hands up forward. That was square two. Now I'm going down the long straightaway into square number three. This is so much better than just riding a circle. Here I come. Now I'm going to start that whole pattern again. Here I go. Square number one. Heading over here to square number two. Down the long straightaway. Square number three. Square number four. Now I'm preparing for a stop. Whoa. Boom. Wow. That's riding some, and that's fun. I'll take the air out of you too a little bit. So, some place to go, something to do, fun pattern, unending pattern.
Hey, thank you for watching Better Horses. If you missed any of our television shows, you can check us out at betterhorses.com and see all of our episodes.
And if you want more Better Horses Radio, go to the app and type in Better Horses, and you give us all you want.
And take a look at our newspaper coming out five times a year on the same website.
You're going to love us.